everyone, my name is Ankita and welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to show you 4 easy ways how you can light up your house this Diwali. These are some last minute decoration ideas. They are very inexpensive and they can be made with stuff that you might have lying around the house. So without any further ado, let's get started. I already have a video on my channel on how you can make this beautiful Lord Ganesha showpiece and tea light holders using an ordinary tray, a Lord Ganesha murti and a few pista shells. This showpiece will be perfect as a Diwali decoration. So if you haven't already, please do check that video out. I will leave the link in the description box.
The first idea that I'm going to share in this video is this beautiful tea light holder. Using an old CD, a few small rhinestones and these small paisley patches. You can use kundan or bigger rhinestones in place of these patches and a tea light candle. You will also need some glue. You can use hot glue or you can even use fevicol. All the materials with online links to buy them will be listed in the description box. Attach the tea light candle to the center of the CD using some hot glue. Then arrange the paisley patches on the CD however you want. You can use hot glue or fevicol to fix them in place. Do the same with the small rhinestones. You can follow the design that I'm showing or you can make any other pattern that you like. After fixing everything in place, the first candle holder is ready. The second idea is a DIY floating candle. I have chosen a mandala design. To make this, you will need an OHP sheet, a 3D acrylic outliner and glass painting colors. I have already drawn the design on a piece of paper. Using some tape, I am going to attach the design to the back of the OHP sheet. Turn the sheet over and then start drawing, following the lines. Here I am using a golden 3D acrylic outliner. You can use any color of your choice. You can follow the design that I am doing or you can make your own design. Just make sure that your design fits well into the container in which you want to place your candles. After completing the outline of the mandala design, I am going to let it dry completely and then fill in the design with glass painting colors. You do not have to use the colors that I am using. You can choose the colors according to your preference. After completely filling in the design with colors, I'm going to let it dry completely. Once it's dry, remove the paper from the back. And then cut it out. And the floating candle holder is also ready. To use this, simply place the OHP sheet in a bowl or tray filled with water. To decorate it further, you can also use a few flower petals and then place a tea light candle in the middle of the OHP sheet. This is how you can convert a normal candle into a floating candle without spending too much. You can make this in a variety of designs and use them every year, and it looks absolutely gorgeous. To make the third design, you will need a CD as a base, 4 bangles. I have these really old curved bangles. You can use simple round bangles or even the fancy decorated ones. I am also going to use 2 different lace, a few ghungroos and a few kundan and beads to decorate the CD. You will also need an LED diya. You will also need some hot glue to fix everything in place. If you do not have a hot glue gun, I will highly recommend that you get one. It's really useful. Hot glue guns are nowadays available in any big craft store, or you can even get them online. In case you want to buy it online, I'm going to place a link in the description box. To decorate the bangles, I'm going to stick a fancy lace on top of the bangle using some hot glue. After covering the entire bangle, I'm going to trim off the excess lace. I will need two such bangles. For the remaining two bangles, I'm just going to wrap some golden lace around the bangles, covering the bangles entirely, and then cut off the excess. I'm going to stick a few ghumrus to the top of one golden lace wrapped bangle. If you choose to use a fancy decorated bangle, then you can obviously skip these steps. After attaching all the ghumrus, attach the bangle with a fancy lace to the CD first using some hot glue, followed by the plain golden lace wrapped bangle, then again the one with the fancy lace. Finally, fix the bangle with the ghumrus on top. You can leave it like that, and to use it, just place the LED diya in the middle. Or you can also decorate the CD with some kundans, beads and ghumrus like I have done. And the third candle holder is also ready. The fourth candle holder is really easy to make. It's a DIY lotus candle holder. It's a last minute DIY decoration. To make it, you will need pink and green papers, a LED diya, and some glue. Here you can use hot glue or even fevicol. Place the diya on the green paper and draw a circle. Cut out the paper, leaving a little bit of extra space like I have done. You will also need some pink rectangular pieces of paper in three different sizes. You will need 6 papers, with each paper measuring 6 cm in length and 5 cm in width. The second set should have 5 papers, with each paper measuring 5 cm in length and 4 cm in width. The last set should have 4 papers, with each paper measuring 3 cm in length and 2 cm in width. Then fold each set of paper in half and then cut them out in the shape of a petal. Repeat the same for all the 3 sets of papers. Then again make a small cut on the petals like shown. Do this for all the petals. Then apply glue to one side of the petal and then stick the other side on top. Repeat this step for all the petals. Then stick the petals one by one on the green paper, starting with the larger petals first, followed by the smaller petals like shown. This design will look even better if you use 3 shades of pink to make the lotus. After attaching all the petals, the lotus candle holder is ready. To use it, just place an LED diya in the middle. You can make multiple of these and decorate them all around the house, and they will look really pretty. Please let me know which one of these was your favorite. I wish you all a very happy and safe Diwali. I hope you liked this video. If you did, then please give it a thumbs up. Please do share my videos with your friends and family. It will mean a lot to me. And also subscribe to my channel. Press the bell icon so that you get notified every time I upload a new video. You can also connect with me on all my other social media, links to which will be in the description box. Thanks for watching. Bye.